you could tell me about Sidney Pollack.
Sidney Pollack, a very good director. I mean, he was, I think I interviewed him for our show, Saturday Night the Movies. We did him in, I believe, 1975. He was traveling through Toronto to promote 3 Days of the Condor.
Yeah.
And we wanted to catch up to him. I mean, incredibly articulate, and was a director who really believed in delivering entertainment.
One of the things that trapped me with him early on was a war movie he did in the late 60s called Castle Keep, which I think is based
on Burt Lancaster, yes.
Yeah.
Benjamin! Hear this, sir? They're doing it, Beckman. Benjamin!
Sir!
Look for him. In the chapel. Is that where you said, Beckman?
Well, I took to lockdown, she was.
I want you to make it out too, Beckman.
I can't.
How do you feel?
You're all right, sir. There's only something wrong with my legs. They won't move.
Where's Alistair?
Here, sir.
We can haul till you make it down the stairs.
Sir, we could all make it down through the passageway.
No, we can't. Beckman and I are hit. You sure you can't make it out, Beckman?
I'm certain, sir.
Alistair. Yes, all Benjamin.
Major Faulkner.
Get going.
Captain Beckman?
Get going.
And if you don't know the story, it's actually a pretty common model now, but at the time, I think it was pretty innovative. And I saw it on TV as a young kid, and I didn't realize why we didn't have access to this movie. And the reason I had heard, and Dr. Pittman, with a PhD in film knowledge and all things related to it, can maybe correct me on this, is that film was part of the prosecution or the defense strategy in the Defeo murders, which became the framework for the Amityville Horror case. Supposedly, Ronnie DeFeo was watching Castle Keep, and there's different stories about his state of mind and what he may have been on, but he's watching Castle Keep, and the violence of that movie is what triggered him. I'm paraphrasing the court situation, which triggered him to go on his rampage, which to me was sort of made the reason that movie was not readily available on video or DVD for years, you could not find a copy of that.
No, that's interesting. I've never heard that story. I know the one story I did hear, which goes along with that, was there were a couple of cases in England in early 1972 after the release of Clockwork Orange. where that was cited as a reason why some crimes were committed. And it upset Stanley Kubrick so much that he got Warner Brothers to agree to pull Clockwork Orange from release in England for over 20 years because that did upset him. And he was quite hurt by that. And he was getting threats as well. So he pulled the film from release. Now, I'm not sure. I haven't heard that story about Castle Keep, but I know it's very difficult to find that film, even to this day.
It went through a major drought. And I mean, it's one of the hallmark. I mean, it is an anti-war film, and you can get a sense of what their approach was. But the way they framed that up, to give the audience the setup of the movie we're talking about, it's somewhere, the timeline is somewhere around the Battle of the Bulge. And there's like a weary American platoon making it through the forest. They find a French castle, and whether through insanity or justification of their roles in the war or whatever, they decide to fortify the castle, realizing it's on the crossroad with two like major German divisions coming down. And they do everything that kids do when they play in the sandbox. They put gasoline in the moats, and they blow anti-tank obstacles in the forest, and they fortify this medieval castle and sort of almost kind of cross, you know, the historical timelines with like what you would think would be like a 12th century battleground. Mm-hmm. And then of course everything gets blown sky high. Now that's a Sidney Pollack movie from I think 68, 69, but that's
right. Yeah.
And what I'm claiming about the DeFeo's case was something that was put forward by DeFeo's defense attorney, William Weber. So it's interesting. I don't know if it was true. It is actually in court documents. I don't know if that's the reason, but sometimes filmmakers and studios get very sensitive, and I'm sure you've experienced this, with how their work is interpreted. I don't know. Did you like that movie when you saw it?
I did like that movie, and I certainly don't buy into the idea that viewing a film would cause somebody to commit a crime. It may be a minor contributing factor, but
right. I agree.
I'm sure all the reasons that crime was committed were there long before that person ever saw a movie. So I just don't. It's a very good excuse and I guess a popular defense, but I certainly don't buy into it.
Yeah. The movie's got Bruce Dern playing crazy, big surprise. Burt Lancaster played basically the hard-edged military commander. Again, no surprise, but the fact that they're not surprises doesn't bother us during the movie, I think. It's almost like fitting it. It's got one of the all-time great lines. One of the guys goes AWOL into a bakery. He was like a baker in a past life, Peter Falk, and he decides he's just, with the bombs going off, destroying the town, he's going to start baking bread. It's like some sort of therapy, or like say it's all over, basically. And there's only like 8 or 9 of these guys, and 2 of them go to get him, and they're like, "Hey, we're taking you back to base." He's like, "I'm not going." And he goes, "Well, why aren't you going?" He's like, "Because it's over. It's all over." And he says something to the effect of, "He's like, well, don't worry, because we have a plan." He's like, "Yeah, what's that?" He's like, "We're going to win the war." And he goes, "It's been tried before." He says, I'm not doing it justice, but he's like, "Well, we've got a plan for the Germans. What is it? It's to win the war." He's like, "Hey, it's been tried before." He's like, "On D-Day, I was going to win the war that day." And then he's like, by something else, or in Africa, I was going to win the war that day. By D-Day, I thought, okay, maybe it's going to take a month. Now I realize this shit's going to go. It's interesting the way those actors, I mean, just brought that movie to life. And it's definitely a dark film.
Your road to redemption is paved with tombstones. No Quarter, Kill All Masters. Go to NoQuarterKillAllMasters.com. Rated R.